अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृत वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विजाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। Correction. Yesterday I got a little confused with since I was trying to finish this in a hurry. Rajastamasi abhibhuyod bhutaha yaha sattvaguna sa shuddha sattvaguna iti abhidhiyate. And then I read this Rajastamo bhyam abhibhuta yaha sattvaguna sa malina sattvaguna iti kirtyate. So this bhyam was in my mind when I read this also. I didn't read this again. So therefore, I thought that this should be negated, anabhibhuya. But here it is, kartari prayoga, sattva gunaha, shuddha sattva guna iti abhidhiyate. What kind of sattva gunaha? Rajastamasi abhibhuya yaha udbhuta. Yaha sattva guna, rajastamasi abhibhuya udbhuta. So, here it is, rajastamasi hi, rajas and tamas. It is rajastamasi in dual, but it is second case. And here, abhibhuya, labanta. So sattva guna is overpowering. Here it is said that rajastamo bhyam abhibhuta yaha sattva guna. So sattva guna which is overpowered by rajas and tamas. Here it is said sattva guna which having overpowered rajastamas. So here sattva guna is the construct is different. So here sattva guna overpowers the rajas and tamas. Therefore it is shuddha sattva guna and therefore predominant. And although translation wise I explained it properly, but the construct I was a little confused with this bhyam setting in my mind. So rajastamo bhyam abhibhuta ya sattva guna. So the sattva guna which is overpowered by rajas and tamas is malina sattva guna. Therefore sattva guna is not predominant anymore, it is influenced by rajas and tamas, and therefore avidya at the ajnana or avidya at the individual level. Anyway, so moving on, the 265th avarta. Say jiyavogartam ishwarasya jagat sisraksha. So srishti icha which is there is for what purpose? Ishwara has it for jiyavoga. This we saw yesterday also. I think we did this also. No, we didn't do this. Okay. So jiyavogartam ishwarasya jagat sisraksha jiva karma phala pradanat यदा ईश्वरः विमुखः भवति तदा जगत् प्रलयो भवति। We have seen this also. I'll quickly go through this section. It is the उत्पत्ति प्रकार and content entire तत्त्वबोध is condensed into condensed and even elaborated at some places. So I'll speed through this. We know this how srishti takes place. So here jiva karma फल प्रदानात् यदा ईश्वरः विमुखः भवति। सो व्हेन ईश्वर नो टर्न्स अवे फ्रॉम फलदातृत्वम् दैट इज ओनली पॉसिबल व्हेन प्रारब्ध इज नॉट ड्यू एट द एंड ऑफ द कल्प एंड देयर इज रिजोल्यूशन एंड काइंड ऑफ अ रिलैक्सेशन टाइम जस्ट लाइक सुषुप्ति इज नित्य प्रलय सिमिलरली प्रलय समय इज लाइक सुषुप्ति अवस्था. It's a long sushupti avastha. Even some upasakas who do avyakta upasana, they desire for that kind of laya. They desire for a long, long, long ananda swarupa sleep. They want to get merged into avyakta and sleep longer. And they know that it is ananda swarupa. Such upasana also exists. So thereby, for those as well as the other jivas to get a break from this samsara, there is pralaya, longer duration of pralaya, longer duration of sushupti. And that is when jiva karma phala pradanat Ishvara is vimukha. He is turned away from giving karma phala to jivas, so they can rest in between till the cycle resumes again. Pralaya sarva pradartha samskara mayayam leena bhavanti. Everything is resolved into, all the samskaras are still there, they are resolved into maya, avyakta. Tasma jivanam karma shesha api sukshma rupena mayayam nilino bhavati. Where is this karma which is due for fructification? It is there in maya itself, it is resolved there. But the individuality, the difference is, although at that point don't seem to be maintained because they are all resolved into one maya tattva, still the individuality connection is retained, as in which karma, which samskara is associated with which jiva. Tasma jivanam karma shesha api sukshma rupena mayam nilino bhavati. Yada praninam karma phaladana abhimukaha bhavati ishvaraha tada jivanam bhogartam aham jagat srije iti ishvarasya ichha jayate. We saw the ichha in Ishvara's sankalpa. The sankalpa rather of Ishvara is because of jiva karma. In totality, whatever is due in that kalpa, that kind of srishti has to be made, and therefore ichha has to be precede. Ichha has to precede that srishti. That ichha is born in keeping with the karma of the jivas, therefore jivanam bhogartham. There's a tippana here which says yatha, I'll skip this, I'll just read this, I don't want to explain much of this, but you get the idea. Yatha putrarthini jaya patya sangata shukrupam bijam tatakramena putrarupen parinatam garbham cha vahanti prasavat purvam santati labha nimittena sada prasanna sattvaguna pradhana iva bhavati. So an explanation, I'll just give a bit there. So just like a you know, lady wanting to become a mother, when she's carrying the child, that's, you see a lot of sattva manifesting. You see the glow in a pregnant woman about to become a mother. There is this motherly glow. She's all waiting for the child. So that is explained, you know, as an example, it is given as sattva guna pradhana, eva, as though sattva guna pradhana. Paschat prasava kale, during the during delivery, the labor pain is immense. So I mean, men cannot even fathom the pain, that kind of pain. So there it is obvious that the pain is unbearable. So the sukha which was in her mind, that after the child is born there's so much of sukha, that sukha is overpowered by this pain. Now why, you know, why that kind of a, it is equally painful for the child which is being born. We saw this. So it's vairagya karaka. But here the comparison is with tamoguna. So there tamoguna overpowers sattva. So that is explained here as to how the sattva guna and tamoguna pradhanatvam takes place. That is explained here, and how Ishvara and Maya gets reconfigured. Ishvara Shakti. Ishvariya Shakti. So paschat prasava kale vedana nimittena prasannatayaha tirodhane sati shunya chitta tamoguna pradhana iva bhavati. She can't even think. The entire focus is on the pain. Can't even think straight at that time. Just wants to get it over with. Yathava purvam shveta varano megha. Another example, how the cloud varsha kale shamo bhavati. Similarly, shuddha maya which is shuddha, just like a cloud which is clear, during the rains it becomes dark. So megha varna. Megha varsha kali shyamo bhavati tatha srishte purvam brahma pratibimba rupa jagat bija dharini avidya upadhika अनंत जीव सहित प्रपंच रूप गर्भधारिणी च शुद्ध सत्व प्रधान माया. सो माया इज शुद्ध सत्व प्रधान बट वेन शी इज अविद्या उपाधिक अनंत जीव सहित प्रपंच रूप गर्भधारिणी एज दो शी इज होल्डिंग द जीवास ऑल द जीवास इंक्लूसिव ऑफ प्रपंच शी इज होल्डिंग इन इन द गर्भ. ईश्वरस्य उपाधि दैट माया ईश्वरस्य उपाधि भवति. सो ईश्वरस्य उपाधि इज मेंशन्ड देयर. सो शी इज द उपाधि ऑफ ईश्वर दैट काइंड ऑफ सत्व गुण प्रधान प्री जीव जगत सृष्टि. जीव सृष्टि एंड जगत सृष्टि इज मैनिफेस्टेशन अगेन द वे इट वाज देयर इन द अर्लियर कल्प इट कंटिन्यूज. पश्चात सृष्ट्यारंभ काले सा माया शुद्ध सत्व स्वरूप तिरोधानेन सृष्टि योग्य तमोगुण प्रधान प्रकृति रूपा भवति. Then she is called as Prakruti. She reconfigures into Srishti Yogyata. Yogyata. She gets Srishti Yogyata. That kind of reconfiguration takes place because Trigunatmika Maya. So Sattva Guna Pradhana Tirodhanena. The Shuddha Sattva Swarupa Tirodhanena. It gets overpowered by Rajas and Tamas as explained and thereby it becomes Srishti Yogya. And then तमो गुण प्रधान प्रकृति रूपा भवति. सो एनीवे वी नो दिस. आई जस्ट वांटेड टू कंप्लीट आई मीन रीड इट आउट फॉर कंप्लीशन. सूक्ष्म सृष्टि निरूपणम. सो नाउ दिस सूक्ष्म एंड स्थूल सृष्टि वी टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस आल स्पीड थ्रू सूक्ष्म पंच. सो आई विल गिव अ पैराग्राफ मीनिंग देयर. सो इट्स क्वाइट ईजी. यू ऑल सीन यू नो द सृष्टि प्रकार इन वेरियस ग्रंथस एटलीस्ट इन तत्वबोध. सूक्ष्म पंचभूतानां तद्गुणानां च उत्पत्तिः एतादृश ईश्वर इच्छावशात् माया तमोगुण प्रधाना भवति. सो माया बिकम्स तमोगुण प्रधान. वी सॉ दैट. एंड देन तादृश तमोगुण प्रधान माया सकाशात् आकाश वायु तेजो जल पृथ्व्यात्मक पंचभूतानि उत्पद्यन्ते. पंच महाभूतास आर बॉर्न फ्रॉम दैट काइंड ऑफ माया विच इज ओवर पावर्ड बाय तमस नाउ रीकॉन्फिगर्ड इन टू तमः प्रधान. तेषु भूतेषु क्रमेण शब्द स्पर्श रूप रस गंधाख्य पंचगुणा वर्तन्ते. नाउ सी दिस क्रम हैज ऑलरेडी बीन निगेटेड एज हैविंग नो तात्पर्य. दैट इज द रीजन वी स्पीड थ्रू दिस. सृष्टि हैज नो तात्पर्य फ्रॉम द श्रुति एंड डेफिनेटली क्रम हैज नो तात्पर्य. सो द गुणास आर इंडिविजुअली टॉक्ड अबाउट बिलोंगिंग टू द पंच महाभूतास. मायायाः सकाशात् शब्द सहित आकाश उत्पन्न. सो आकाशस्य शब्दः आकाशात् वायुः. सो वायु इज मैनिफेस्ट आउट ऑफ आकाश विच इज मैनिफेस्ट आउट ऑफ माया विच इज ब्रह्माश्रिता. एंड देन वायु हैज इट्स ओन गुणा एज वेल. सो ईच ऑफ दीज पंच महाभूतास हैज इट्स ओन गुणा अलॉन्ग विद द अर्लियर गुणा बोरोड फ्रॉम द कारण. वायोः आकाश कार्यत्वात् कारण गुणेन शब्देन स्व असाधारण गुण स्पर्शेन च द्विगुणो वायुः. सो वायु हैज टू गुणास. वन इज इट्स ओन विच इज असाधारण गुण विच इज नॉट देयर एनीवेयर एल्स. इट इज इट्स ओन गुण विच इज व्हाट स्वासाधारण गुण स्पर्शेन. स्पर्श इज गुण ऑफ वायु. इट ऑल्सो बोरोस द गुण फ्रॉम इट्स कारण विच इज आकाश. सो देयर बाय द्विगुण. एंड सिमिलरली Agni, which is born out of Vayu, will have its own guna. It will borrow the two gunas from earlier two. And so on. So now we have this background. I'll just speed through. Vayu ho Agni Sambhuta. Karanakasha Vayu gunabhyam shabdasparshabhyam swasadharana rupa gunena cha trigunaha Agni. Just let me close the window. It's raining here. So that I don't have to yell. So karanakasha vayogni gunaihi shabdasparsha rupaihi swasadharana rasa gunena cha chaturguna apaha adbhya prithvi sambhuta. Karanakasha vayogni gunaihi shabdasparsha rupa rasaihi swasadharana guna gandha gunena swasadharana gandha gunena cha pancha guna prithvi. So in the end the fifth mahabhuta will end up having five gunas, out of which Gandha, Gandhavati, Prithivi. So Gandha is its own Swa Asadharana Guna, whereas it borrows the other four from the earlier four. So this is how Pancha Mahabhutas are manifest. Akashe Pratidhvani Rupa Shabda Vartate. Since Akasha's Guna is Shabda, there is an echoing possible in Akasha. Vayo Bisiti Shabdaha. So there is the Shabda, how it manifests in various elements is shown. Akasha has its own Shabda. So there is an echo there. Here there are some various sounds are explained, how you hear the manifestation of the sound which belongs to Akasha originally, how it manifests in each of the other Mahabhutas. Shitoshna Kathinanam Vilakshana Sparshascha Vartate Agno Bhugbhug Shabdaha Ushna Sparshaha. And then Vayu has Sparsha also. So there is Shitoshna Kathinanam Vilakshana Sparshascha Vartate. So there is Sparsha, which is cold or, you know, cooling, or you feel warmth. So that is the guna there of Vayu, its own guna manifesting. So the two gunas in Vayu have been explained. There is sound which is from Akasha. Agno Bhukbuk Shabda Ushna Sparsha Prakashakhya Rupam Cha Vartate. Prakasha is Agni's own, but it borrows Ushna Sparsha from Vayu. Sparsha from Vayu, but Ushna is manifest in Agni as Ushna. Sparsha becomes Ushna. Bhugbhug Shabda, the sound that, you know, when the fire comes up, this sound is Bhugbhug Shabda. That is not its own Shabda. It is manifest from Akasha, which is its Karana, grandfather Karana rather. Jale Chili Chili Shabdaha Sheeta Sparsha Shukla Rupam Madhura Rasascha Vartate. And then Madhuratvam is its own, Jala's own Guna. Whereas Shukla Rupa, the Rupa is borrowed from Agni, but it manifests as Shukla in Jala. Sparsha is Shita, but Sparsha is not its own Guna. Manifestation of Shitatvam is there in Jala, but Sparsha is the Guna from Vayu. Chili Chili Shabda is from Akasha. But all of these are there in Jala. Lavana Tiktatadi Rasahatu Prithivi Sambandha Deva Jale Vibhanti. So if Jala also has taste, Jala has its taste, own guna is taste. And then the earlier four manifest. But what about the fifth? That is also manifest in Jala, which is the fourth. So there he says, Prithivi Sambandha Deva, because there will be Panchikarana, there will be mixing up of all these. And then when Jala has a taste, that is its own. When just like it has Rupa, that is not its own. Sparsha is not its own. Shabda is not its own. Originally its own. It has all this from its Karana. The Karana Gunas manifest in the Karya. But how is it that something which is Karya, Prithvi, how is that Prithvi Guna, which is Gandha, manifests in Jala? So there is Prithvi Sambandha because of Panchikarana, which will be talked about. We know it as well. Madhuryam eva swabhavika rasa jalasya. The sweetness is its own nature. How do you know that? Such a haritakyamalaka adi bhakshana samskruta rasanaya jalapane abhivyajyate. So some amalaka is amla. You take any a berry, some kind of gooseberry. When it is eaten, you have some kind of a taste, which is bitter. So how can you have sweetness in the taste when you drink water after eating gooseberry, which has a bitter or some kind of a non-sweet? At least the sweetness is not there in the berry. That kind of a berry when you eat, amla, what we call as amla. So that, or haritaki. So there is some other, you know, ingredient which itself does not have sweetness. In fact, it has taste which is opposed to sweetness. Maybe bitter also at times. Especially if you eat a small amla, it is bitter, little bitter. But when you drink water after it, that water tastes sweet. Why? Because although the there is bitter countering the sweetness of water. The water has sweetness which manifests. And this is how everything is explained. Even when you eat sugar, sugar can be defined as sweet, but sugar is not really sweet. Rasa, which the sugar associates with, that is sweet. So rasa is sweet because rasa is the guna of jala. So when the jala rupa on the tongue, when it meets the sharkara, that time there is sweetness manifest from the jala. This is how Nayayika's explanation is given. And this is how we can understand how guna manifests. And why do we need this? Because we want to know how karana manifests in karya. That is the tatparya really. Karana sattva manifests everywhere in the karya. Karana chetana manifests everywhere in the karya. That is the real tatparya. So all this is in its stride, it is explained, but there is no commitment here. Since one may have questions, how does this guna be there in something which is not the karya at all? It is karana, and how can there be karya guna in karya? That is because panchi karana, and this is how it is explained. And the sweetness of jala is also explained with an example. Prithiviyam kadakada shabda. Kadakada shabda is when you see, you know, the landslides and things like that, that time there is sound. That sound is kadakada. This is all dajanta shabda in vyakrana. So one sound, any sound can be converted into pratipadika by adding daj pratya, which causes dvitva, and therefore you can decline that. Now kadakada shabdaha. Then anushna shita sparshaha. Prithvi is neither ushna nor shita, but there is some neutral sparsha. You feel the touch of prithvi. Shukla krishna pita rakta haritadi rupam. All these rupas are there. That is the agni guna. Sparsha is vayu guna. Shabda is the akash guna. Maduramla lavana katu kashaya tiktakhya shadrasaha. The six types of taste which are manifest in prithvi, they are of the jala. And sugandha, which is its own gandha. Sugandha durgandha rupa dvivida gandhascha vartate. So gandha, which is sugandha or durgandha, that is its own prithvi's guna. Ittham akashe eka guna vayu dvau agnau trayaha jale chatvara prithivyam pancha gunaha. It's clear. Tatrapi pratibhutam pratisvika gunaha tu eka eva. Its own guna of all the five mahabhutas, there's only one guna which is in each bhuta, original guna. Taditara gunaha karanat anugataha. So there is anuvritti of karana guna into karya. Sarvasya mula karanam Ishwaraha. Now you have landed on what is the tatparya of this krama. Ishwara is maya sahita chaitanya chidabhasa. Therefore Ishwara being the mula karana, in each and every karya there is Ishwaratvam. Ishwara bhava continues. Ishwara continues to be there in every Mahabhutas, which mix up finally from subtle to gross and then manifest as the Prapancha. So Sarvasya Moola Karanam Ishwarah. Ishwarecha Aumshadvayam Asti. In Ishwara also we have Aumshadvayam, only Chetana Aumsha, Chaitanya Aumsha, Maya Aumsha Chaiti. Chetana Aumsha and Maya Aumsha, both put together we call as Ishwara. Sarveshu Bhuteshu Vidyamanaha Nama Rupatmaka Mithya Aumsha Mayayaha. Nama Rupa is Mithya, whereas Asti Bhati Priya, which is Satchid Ananda or Satyam Jnanam Anantam, that is Ishwara's Chaitanya Amsha Guna. Guna as in Lakshana. It is Guna as in not property really. It is Swarupa Lakshana. Mayayaha Nama Rupa, and then Satta Spurti Rupa Amshastu Chaitanyasya Iti Jnayam. Satta and Spurti are mentioned. Ananda can be added in continuation with the Lakshana. If there is Ananda in any Vishaya, that is because of Sad Brahma, Chid Brahma, Ananda Brahma. Chaturvida Bheda Sahita Antakkarana Utpatti. Antakkarana Utpatti, how does it take place? Because final goal of Jagat Srishti is not creating Jagat itself. Jagat is for Jiva Bhoga. It has been mentioned here, Jiva Bhogartam earlier we have seen this. So jiva bhogartham ishwarasya jagasya sriksha. So jagat prapancha is manifest for the bhoga of jiva. So jiva has to be created in the sense jiva should get an opportunity to undergo bhoga as per the prarabdha carved out from the karma which he has done, karma phala, set of karma phalas which he has earned. Therefore, this jiva is manifest into a particular sharira. Antakkarana association is anadi, but still antakkarana has to be manifest in a proper configuration in a particular sharira, stula sharira, which is part of jagat. So that association is by karma, which is ready for delivering bhoga. So antakkarana, what is this antakkarana also? Antakkarana is also put together, although anadi, it is still having these pancha mahabhutas as basis. So that antakkarana utpatti is described here. Chaturvida bheda sahita antakkarana utpatti. So antakkarana itself works in as four functionaries. Has four functions. So we know that it has antakkarana. Itself is manaha, buddhi, ahankara and chitta. Apanchikruta panchabhutanam sattvagunamsha samashti sattvam ityabhidhiyam abhidhiyam manam antakkaranam utpadayati. So what is the cause, karana for immediate karana? The moola karana is Ishvara, but what is the immediate karana for antakkarana? Sattvaguna samashti. Sattvagunamsha samashtihi. All the sattva gunas of what? Apanchikruta bhuta. Apanchikruta panchamahabhutas. Apanchikruta panchamahabhutas are non-grossified. So subtle. These subtle elements all have sattva, rajas and tamas. So sattva guna, each of the sattva guna causes indriyas. Gives rise to indriyas. Which can cognize its own asadharana guna. Whereas samashti sattva guna together leads to antakkarana. Therefore, sattva gunamsha samashti sattvam iti abhidhiyamanam antakkaranam utpadayati. And that is the reason that antakkarana is called as sattvam also. So, sattva shuddhi, chitta shuddhi, antakkarana shuddhi, even buddhi shuddhi, all these have same connotation. Why is the antakkarana called as sattvam? Because it is born out of sattva guna samashti. Sattva guna amsha samashti. So, all these sattvaguna aushas of the pancha mahabhutas put together give rise to antakkarana. Antakkaranam jnanotpatti hetuhu. And antakkarana itself, when playing the role of buddhi, becomes the hetu for jnanotpatti. Jnanotpatti sattvagunad ityangi kritam. And we know that jnanotpatti is impossible unless sattva is predominant. Sattva has to be there. Tamasika and Rajasika person cannot get jnana. Even if there is jnana, it is jnana bhasa, it won't stay long. So jnanotpatti is sattva gunat, it is well known. Sattva sanjayate jnanam, says Bhagavan Gitacharya Krishna iti. Tasmad antakkaranam bhutanam sattva guna karyam. Therefore, antakkarana is the karya of sattva guna of all the pancha mahabhutas. Tachcha antakkaranam panchikruta panchabhuta vyashti sattva guna karya pancha jnanendriyanam swasva vishayagrahane sahakari. This antakkarana has to back each of the indriyas. Antakkarana has sattva guna of all the pancha mahabhutas, and individual sattva gunas of each of the pancha mahabhutas give rise to indriyas which can cognize their own original guna, but antakkarana has to back. Therefore, this antakkarana should back all the five indriyas, and therefore it is sahakari for vishayagrahana. Tasmadapi panchabhuta samashti sattva guna karyam eva antakkaranam. And thereby also you know, if you know that indriyas individually are sattva guna karya, how do you know that antakkarana is made up of sattva samashti? Because it is needed as a sahakari sadhana for vishaya grahana. न वैशेषिकादीनाम इव अंतकरणम नित्यम एंड दिस अंतकरण इज नॉट नित्य द वे वैशेषिकास से तार्किकास अंतः इज इक्वल टू सो अंतः इज एक्सप्लेन अंतः इज देहस्य अंतस्तित्वा देयरफॉर अंतः करणम बिकॉज ज्ञान साधनम इति अंतकरणम उच्यते सो इट्स मिक्सिंग अप विद इंग्लिश इज अ लिटिल ऑड अंतः देहस्य अंतस्तित्वा करणम ज्ञान साधनम इति अंतकरणम उच्यते इत्यतः दिस इज द रीजन व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड अंतकरण अंत बिकॉज इट इज विद इन एंड करणम बिकॉज इट इज ज्ञान साधनम पंचभूत समष्टि सत्वगुण कार्यत्वेन अंतकरणम सत्वमित्यपि कीर्त्यते एंड दिस वी ऑलरेडी सॉ सत्वगुण कार्य इन कॉम्बिनेशन देयरफॉर आल्सो सत्वम अंतकरण परिणामस्य वृत्तिरिति संज्ञा एंड अंतकरण अंडरगोज अ चेंज मॉडिफाइज इन कीपिंग विद द विषय देन इट गेट्स द नेम एज वृत्ति That is what vritti rupa jnana antakarana modifies itself. Chitta vritti nirodha is yoga. So chitta vritti antakarana vritti meaning modification of antakarana. Reconfigure parinama antakaranasya vrittaya chatasra. What are the vrittis of antakarana? Tatra padarthasya swarupa. Sorry, padarthasya swarupa. It is actually nischayatmika. I think there is
Ishika.
Sorry?
Nischayayika.
Nischayayika, is it? Okay. Nischayayika or nischayatmika vrittihi buddhi. So there is a typo nonetheless. Sankalpatmika vrittihi manaha. And then chintanatmika vrittihi chittam. Aham iti abhimanatmika vrittihi ahankaraha. So there is atmika everywhere. So this would also likely be atmika, not nischaya. So it's okay. Either way you understand it is nischa, nischa is there, nischayika if you add. So nischaya, atmika maybe. Basically the swabhava of that vritti. What is the nature of that vritti? Based on that, you give that antakarana's functionary a name. So buddhi is that which is nischaya atmika, which can resolve the doubts raised by the manaha. So manaha is sankalpatmika, sankalpa vikalpatmika. Tattva bodha sankalpa vikalpatmika, atmikam manaha. So mind is that which gives options every time. Resolution is due to buddhi. So the same antakarana behaves as mana, gives you options, raises doubts. Answer is given by using buddhi. Same antakarana is configured as buddhi. Chintanatmika vrittihi chittam. So the antakarana vritti, modification of antakarana is in such a manner that it allows chintana. Chintana is possible when there is smriti earlier. Earlier smriti should be there because current data is to be compared. Therefore, that it is chitta is facilitating memory and thereby helping manaha to raise doubts or compare. Buddhi decides finally. So nischayatmika. Aham iti abhimanatmika vritti ahankara. And the identification, I am that thinker, I am that dullard, or I am the one who is confused by mana, I am the one who is, you know, uses buddhi and decides an intellectual, or I have a great memory or a bad memory, that is an individual, that individuality is created by ahankara. The vritti in the antakarana, meaning modification of antakarana, is in the form of identification, individuality, that is ahankara. Panchabheda sahita pranotpattihi. Now pranas are mentioned here. There are pranas and upapranas. So I'll just read this out again. There is no commitment here. And various ways these pranas are explained, that is mentioned and resolved by the sadhu here. Apanchikrita panchabhuta samashti rajogunaushat panchavritti prana sambhutah. So prana also has five vrittis, five modifications. Pancha prana. Just like antakarana has four modifications. This is also subtle. Apanchi krita panchabhuta samashti rajoguna amsha. So raja, rajoguna, which is samashti rajoguna in totality of the five pancha mahabhutas, which are subtle, not grossified. They come together and give rise to panchavritti prana. So panchavritti ka prana. Panchavritti prana is panchavritti ka prana. that prana which has five vrittis. Sa pranaha kriyabheda sthanabheda cha panchavidaha. So kriyabheda, because of sthana is also where that prana manifests, what is its residing place and what is the activity that it leads to, or what is it, the activity that it takes care of. Based on that, there is five types. So you have prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. Yasya hridayam sthanam kshit pipase kriya sapranaha. So that prana modification is itself called as prana. The one type of prana is prana itself, is called prana, which is in hridaya and gives rise to hunger and thirst. Yasya gudaha sthanam mutra purishayoho adaha nayanam. So adho nayanam kriya sa apanaha. That which purges all the filth from the body, that is apanaha. Yasya nabhi sthanam bhukta pita yoho annapanayo pachana yogya samikaranam kriya sa samana. Samana is the digestive prana. Yasya kanta sthanam shwasa kriya sa udanaha. Udana is udana vayu, udana prana is that which is in the kantha and shwasa kriya. Here shwasa has to be understood. It is breathing in totality. It is not inhalation or exhalation, but it is that which helps the prana stay in the body itself. Meaning helps the sukshma sharira to stay in the sharira. That's why it controls the breathing one way or the other. How is that? It is manifest when you are breathing normally, that time there is not much of udana activity seen. But if you ingest something which is not agreeable to the sharira or to the stomach, then it has to be thrown out. And when it's thrown out, you see in the act of purging from the mouth, so when you throw up, so that time it is seen. And another time the udana is completely manifest is in marana kala. It helps throw up the sukshma sharira from the stula sharira. So it ejects the sukshma sharira from the stula sharira and causes the jiva to transmigrate into another sharira, another loka ichari. So that is the udana prana kriya. Yasya sarva shariram sthanam annapanadi rasasya sarvanadishu praveshanam kriya sas vyanaha. Vyana is all pervasive in the sharira and helps nutritions to be spread around. Kvachit naga kurva. So there is another set of divisions, upapranas. So these are mentioned here. Kvachit naga kurma krukara devadatta dhananjayakhyaha panchavayavaha adhikataya patyante. Other than these five, some other five are read upaprana. Tatra udvamana krun nagaha unmilana hikkadi krutak krut kurmaha kshuta hetuhu krukaraha jhrumbana karaha devadattaha shvayathukaraha dhananjayaha ete upavayavaha. So eta upavayas, ete upavayava. So upavayavas, these are mentioned, they have specific roles mentioned, not important. Tesham cha prithvi jala tejo vayavakashanam rajogunamshebhya kramena utpatti. So individually these are talked about as born out of rajogunamsha of the pancha mahabhutas. Tathayeva apana samana pranavadana vyananam api kramena prithiviyadi nam ekaikasya rajogunamsha utpatti. Again, if you take the pancha pranas, they are also born from the rajoguna of each of the pancha mahabhutas. Sarvesham samashti rajogunamsha no utpatti iti cha uktam kvachit granteshu. So somewhere it is mentioned, it is not from samashti. These pranas are born from individual. Okay, anyway. Parantu. So now he contrasts this as to which way is the right perspective. So he gives his viewpoint there. Parantu advaita siddhante esha prakriya nasti. In advaita siddhanta, we don't agree with this prakriya. Vidyaranya Swami Bihi Panchi Karana Granthe Vartika Karaischa Sukshma Sharire. Sukshma Sharire ke Pancha Koshecha Naga Kurma Adiram Grahanam Nakritam. So these Upapranas, Upavayavas are not mentioned by either Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya or Vartikakara or any of the other granthas which are considered important in Advaita. Apicha taihi apanadi panchapranam panchabhuta samashti rajogunamshad utpatti varnita. Individual utpatti is not talked about. Samashti rajogunamsha is taken and pranas are said to be born out of those. Therefore, tasmad ekaika bhuta vyashti rajogunamshad apanadi nam utpatti kathanam ayuktam eva. So individuals are not the source, but samashti rajogunamsha is the source. This is the paksha that is agreeable to Advaita Siddhanta. Tasmat sukshma sharire naga kurmadinam grahanam asangatam. Upavayavas are also not important there. Pancha prana namiva sukshma sharire grahanam yuktam. We talk about pancha prana. Therefore, even in any other thing, we don't talk about the devadatta, dhananjaya, all these. Only prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana is talked about. Even in ahutis also, these are talked about, not the other five. Kincha prano vikshepa rupa. Prana is vikshepa rupa. Therefore, rajogunasya vikshepa swabhavaha. So, you know, rajoguna brings a vikshepa. Tamas will make a person lie down. Sattva, you see, jnana karana. What is bridging the gap between the two? That is, making the person from lazy to get jnana, you cannot sleep and get jnana. First, you have to become active, jump off the bed and then get active and then control that rajas to get into sattvika mode and then thereby tap the jnana which is available. So vikshepa is svabhava rajoguna. Tasmat panchabhuta rajogunamshat pranotpatti kathanam yuktam eva. Because rajoguna svabhava is vikshepa, therefore the rajoguna being the, you know, ausha, rajoguna ausha being the karana is appropriately explained. Jnanendriyanam karmendriyanam cha utpattihi. How does these jnanendriyas and karmendriyas come about? We know this. Apanchi krutai krita eka eka bhuta sattva gunamshat pancha jnanendriyani rachitani. Individual sattva guna of the pancha mahabhutas are karana for individual jnanendriyas. Eka eka rajogunamshat eka ekam karmendriyam rachitam. Similarly, individual rajogunas of pancha mahabhutas are karana for karmendriyas, individual karmendriyas. Akasha sattvagunas shrotram, vayo sattvagunamshat tvak, tejasa sattvagunamshat netram, jalasya sattvagunamshat rasana, prithivya sattvagunamshat ghranam cha ajayata. Etani panchendriyani jnanasya sadhanani. So we know jnana indriyas, how they are born, and jnanasya sadhanam kim. We need pancha indriyas. Without indriyas, you cannot have any cognition. So for any cognition, you need indriyas. They are pramana. Ataha jnanendriyani iti uchyante. Therefore, why these indriyas are called as jnanendriyas, these sense organs? Because they lead to jnana. Whether it is rupa jnana, shabda jnana, rasa jnana ityadi, each are leading to jnana. Therefore, being the sadhana for jnana, they are called as jnanendriyas. Jnanam sattvaguna jayate. This we already know. Atascha etani panchendriyani bhutanam sattva gunad utpannatvena uchyante. Therefore, you know, sattva, without sattva guna there cannot be jnana. Since there is jnana due to these indriyas, their karana has to be sattva guna. This is how it is inferred. So there is, all this is inferred, can also be inferred. Shrotrendriyam akashasya gunam shabdam grunhati iti tadakashasya sattva guna karyam. And what does Akasha Karya talked about as Shrotrendriya, the sense organ of hearing. It hears only Shabda, which is the guna of Akasha. And since it helps you get the jnana of Shabda, Shabda jnana, therefore it is born out of Sattva guna. And since it helps you cognize Shabda, therefore it is born out of Akasha. So this is how it can be inferred, they can be put together. Evam eva yadyad indriyam yasya yasya bhutasya gunam grinati tat tasya bhutasya sattva guna karyam iti jneyam. So with vipsa you can, you say yat yat and yasya yasya, it will come together with all the individual jnana indriyas and their vishayas, which are the guna of their karana. आकाश से रजोगुणशात गुणांशात वाक, वायु हो रजोगुणशात पाणी ही, अग्नि हे रजोगुणांशात पाद, जल से रजोगुणांशात उपस्थ, पृथिव्या रजोगुणांशात गुदम च उत्पद्यते विनोदी, स्त्री योनौ पुरुष लिंगे च वर्तमान विषयानंद लव साधनम इंद्रियम उपस्थ इति उपस्थम इत्युच्यते. देयर इज सम आई थिंक अनुस्वारा नॉट अनुस्वारा मकार इज नॉट सीन हियर और उपस्था इट इज विसर्ग लोप ओके सॉरी इट उपस्था इट इज पुल्लिंग. कर्म इति क्रिया उच्यते एतानि पंचेन्द्रियाणि. सो कर्मेन्द्रियाणि, व्हाट इज कर्मेन्द्रियाणि? क्रिया इंद्रियाणि इत्यर्थ. सो कर्म मीन्स इन द इंद्रिय, इंद्रियाज वी नो आर साधना, बट व्हाट इज अ साधना फॉर फॉर क्रिया, नॉट ज्ञान. सो देयरफॉर दे आर कॉल्ड एज कर्मेन्द्रिय मीनिंग क्रिया, क्रिया साधक इंद्रियाज और क्रिया साधन इंद्रियाज, नॉट साधक साधन. एतानि पंचेन्द्रियाणि क्रिया साधनत्वात् कर्मेन्द्रियाणि इति अभिधीयन्ते. क्रियायाः रजोगुण कार्यत्वात् भूतानां रजोगुणांशात् कर्मेन्द्रियोत्पत्ति वर्णिता, इत्थं सूक्ष्म सृष्टि निरूपिता. सो सूक्ष्म सृष्टि इज ओवर विद दिस टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट बेसिकली सूक्ष्म शरीर कम्स अबाउट फ्रॉम पंचमहाभूतास विच आर सूक्ष्म, देयरफॉर सूक्ष्म शरीर. देन इंद्रियाज आर इंक्लूडेड विच आर नॉट ओनली ज्ञानेन्द्रियाज ऑल्सो कर्मेन्द्रियाज, फाइव ईच. एंड देन यू ऑल्सो हैव अंतकरण एंड प्राण. Antakarana is fourfold. So that's all the idea of Sukshma Srushti here is. Sukshma Srushti Upasamhara. Conclusion of Sukshma Srushti is what? Apanchikrita Bhutani Tatkare Bhutantakarana Pranakarmendriyani Sukshma Srushti iti Kirtyate. So this manifestation of Sukshma Sharira with the Sukshma Karanas is called as Sukshma Srushti. Sukshma Srushti Vishayakam Jnanam Na Indriyehi Utpadyate. However, how do you know this Sukshma Sharira itself? These Sukshma Indriyas, Prana, all these are not known by Indriyas themselves. Indriya cannot know them, cannot help you know Indriyas. So how do you know Manaha? How do you know Indriyas? So Sukshma Srishti Vishayakam Jnanam Na Indriyaihi Utpadyate. The subtle is not known by Indriyas themselves. Netra Nasikadi Golakani Tu Yajyapi Indriya Vishayani. Although you can know the Indriya Golakas, I can see the eye through the Indriyas. I can feel the eyes through the Indriyas. Feel in the sense touch the eye. I can touch the eye, touch the ear, I can see the ear. But I may not be able to see my own eye. I can see the eye in the mirror or I can see others' eyes. I can see the skin, I can see the tongue, I can see the nose also, but these are golakas. Indriyas cannot be cognized. See, hear, touch, all of these are included there. It is upalakshana. So, netra nasikadi golakani tu yadyapi indriya vishyani tathapi tattad golakantasta indriyani na kasya chiddapi indriyasya vishayi bhavanti. However, the indriyas which are sitting within the golakas, they cannot be cognized by any sense organ. Sukshma srishti utpatyananta anantaram ishvara ichchaya stula srishti nimittam bhutanam panchikaranam nishpadyate. So sukshma srishti utpatti anantaram, after the srishti of sukshma shariras, sukshma padarthas and then sukshma sharira, ईश्वर इच्छया थ्रू द ईश्वर इच्छा स्थूल सृष्टि निमित्तं भूतानां पंचीकरणं निष्पद्यते. नाउ दिस पंचीकरण इज फैसिलिटेटेड, इट टेक्स प्लेस. पंचीकरण इज मिक्सिंग ऑफ दिस सटल टू बिकम ग्रॉस. सो देयरफॉर इट इज ग्रॉसिफिकेशन. एंड नाउ फॉर दिस ऑल्सो देर आर वेरियस वेज टॉक्ड अबाउट, टू वेज रियली डिटेल्स. वन इज मेंशन इन तत्वबोध, अदर्स एल्सवेयर. सो जस्ट लाइक द अर्लियर प्राण एंड पंच पंच प्राणास एंड देन पंच उप प्राणास, साधु गेव हिज ओन ओपिनियन एंड एनालिसिस एज टू विच इज बेटर आउट ऑफ दिस इन अद्वैत सिद्धांत. सिमिलरली हियर ही टेक्स अप दिस स्थूल सृष्टि एंड पंचीकरण प्रकार. पंचीकरणे दो प्रकार उक्तौ, टू टाइप्स ऑफ पंचीकरणास आर मेंशन. प्रथम प्रकार तु एवम् विच इज सीन इन तत्वबोध, एकैक सूक्ष्म भूतस्य तमोगुणांशं साम्येन द्विधा विभजेत तत्र एकम अर्धम पृथक अवस्थापयेत. सो यू डिवाइड दी पंच महाभूतास ईच ऑफ देम इनटू टू, यू सेट असाइड वन. सो एनीवे आई एक्सप्लेन दी ओवरऑल. तत्र एकम अर्धम पृथक अवस्थापयेत तथा अपरम अर्धम साम्येन चतुर्धा विभजेत एवं पुनः विभागेन निष्पन्नम एकैक भूतस्य अष्टमांशं पृथक अवस्थापितेन स्वस्वेतर भूत चतुष्टयस्य अर्धभागेन योजयेत एवं पंचीकरणं निष्पद्यते तत्र एकैकस्मिन्नपि स्थूलभूते एकम अर्धम स्वांशः अपरम अर्धम तु स्वेतरे एकैक भूताष्टांश मेलनेन निष्पन्नम् एवं एकैकस्मिन्नपि स्थूलभूते पञ्चानामि भूतानां अंशसत्त्वात् स्थूलभूतानि पञ्चीकृतानि इति वर्ण्यन्ते. सो स्थूल भूताज आर पंचीकृत ग्रॉसिफाइड हाउ बाय मिक्सिंग अप विथ अदर्स इन व्हाट प्रपोर्शन रिटेनिंग हाफ ऑफ इट्स ओन एंड लेंडिंग दी वन एट्थ ऑफ इट्स ओन टू अदर फोर एंड बोरोइंग वन एट्थ ऑफ अदर्स इट्सेल्फ. सो ईच ऑफ दी ग्रॉसिफाइड महाभूतास विल हैव 50% ऑफ इट्स ओन एंड वन एट्थ ऑफ अदर्स देयर बाय इट बिकम्स whole where 50% is its own and 50% is the mixture of others. So Akasha has 50% of Akasha and 1/8 of the others, other four, 1/8 of Vayu, 1/8 of Agnihi, 1/8 of Jala and 1/8 of Prithvi. So this is one setup. Similarly, the other Mahabhutas will also retain their half and the other half will be an equal mixture of other Mahabhutas except for itself. So other Mahabhutas. This is Panchikarana. Now here, this is one Prakriya. We'll come back to this Prakriya. Other Prakriya, Prakara, where it is mentioned how Panchikarana is done. Dvitiya Prakarastu evam, ekaika sukshma bhutasya tamogunamsham vaishamyena dvidha yuvajet. So there is no equal division. There is a unequal division of the Mahabhutas. And this is preferred by the sadhu. We'll see why. तत्र एकः भागः चतुर्भिः अंशैः निष्पन्नः अपरस्तु भागः पञ्चमांशेन तत्र चतुरंश निष्पन्नम् अधिकपरिमाणकं भागं पृथक् अवस्थापयेत्. सो अधिकपरिणाम यू डोंट नीड 50% मोर देन 50% हियर इट हैपेंस टू बी 80% दो 80% ऑफ इट्स ओन इज रिटेन्ड एंड देन यू हैव बिट्स एंड पीसेस ऑफ अदर्स. सो दैट्स हाउ इट इज. इट इज गोइंग टू नॉट 80% 80% प्लस एडिशनल इज ऑल्सो देयर. पंचमांश निष्पन्नम न्यून परिमाणकम भागम पुनः पंचदा विभजेत तत्र एकम अंशम पृथक अवस्थापित अधिक परिमाणक पंचभागेषु पृथक पृथक योजयेत अनेनापि प्रकारेण पंचीकरणं सिध्यति. सो देयर आर टू प्रकारस. इन वन देयर इज 50% ऑफ वन ओन अंश एंड दी रेस्ट आर मिक्सचर्स ऑफ अदर्स बट दे ऑल टोटल टू 50%. However, in the second prakara, there is more of its own and less of the others in combination also. So this is better, says the sadhu here. Tatra prathama prakare pratibhutam ekam ardham swamshah aparam ardham tu svetara bhuta chatushtayasya amshah yatha akashi ekam ardham swasya eva amshah dvitiyam ardham tu vayor ashtamamshena tejasa ashtamamshena jalasya ashtamamshena prithivya ashtamamshena cha nishpannam एवं भूतांतरेषु अपि ऊयम्. द्वितीय प्रकारे तु प्रतिभूतम् एकः भागः स्वकीयैः एकविंशति अंशैः निष्पन्नः. सो हियर यू हैव यू नो 21 आउट ऑफ 25. सो इफ यू डिवाइड इट द डिविजन इज सच दैट यू हैव 21 आउट ऑफ 25 ऑफ इट्स ओन. द्वितीय भागस्तु स्वेतिर भूतानां चतुर्भिः अंशैः निष्पन्नः यथा आकाशे एकः भागः स्वकीय एकविंशत्यंशात्मकः अपर भागस्तु वायोः पञ्चविंशांशेन तेजसः पञ्चविंशांशेन जलस्य पञ्चविंशांशेन पृथिव्याः पञ्चविंशांशेन च निष्पन्नः. सो दि सेटअप इज दैट यू हैव मोर ऑफ इट्स ओन अंश अलॉट मोर. सो यू हैव यू नो लाइक only one out of 25th part of other, whereas the one of 24th of others. So all four put together, you get 4 out of 25. And 21 out of 25 Amusha is retained its own. Thereby, what will happen is that Prithvi will have more of Prithvi and very less of others. And this is better. That's what he thinks there. And it is easier to explain as to why Prithvi, you see only Prithvi, you don't feel the others. This is because there is a lot of Prithvi in Prithvi Tattva. Jala, etc. are lesser. Much, much lesser. So, evam bhutantareshu api uhaniyam. Pratha prakara apeksha dvitiya prakare pratibhutam swamshadhikyad vivichya pruthak pruthak akasha idam bhanam sugatam bhavati. It is easier to see akasha, vayu, ityadi. Seeing more of akasha, vayu than anything else, that is because others are not in equal measure. Others total up in equal measure in the tattva bodha prakara, but in this prakara, others do not have an equal value weighing against its own original content, but each Mahabhuta has a lot of their own presence and very little of others. This is how it is better, says Sadhu. So here, Tippana Karas, Pratham Prakare Pratibhutam Ardhavagasya Swakiyatve Api Itarardhavagasya Svetara Bhuta Chatushtayamsha Nishpannatva Tena Bhagina Swabhagasya Tirodhanam Sambhavyeta. So, other four being in equal measure can overpower the 50% of any Pancha Mahabhuta. This may be the thinking. So, how is it that you feel only one particular Mahabhuta is there? Tatascha akashadinam bhutanam pratyekam prutak prutak bhanam durgatam syaditi matva yatha pratibhutam swamshadikyam syat tatha dvitiya prakara ashriyate. Second is better because you can explain easier as to how there is more manifestation of any one Mahabhuta when any one is taken after grossification. So that is Sukshma and Stula Shrishti. Now in Stula Brahmanda Adyutpatti, how did these others Brahmanda come about? We look at that. Evam panchikrita bhutebhya indriya gocharam stula brahmandam utpadyate tasmin brahmande bhurvasva Mahar janas tapas satya iti upari saptalokaha. So there are these seven lokas upwards which are stula. These are the lokas. Atala, sutala, patala, vitala, rasatala, talatala, mahatala ityadha sapta lokaha vartante. And then there are five lokas below which are called as talas also. These are the 14 lokas. Eshu chaturdashasu lokeshu vasatam jivanam pruthak pruthak upabhoga yogyan yogya annapanadikam deva manushya pashwadi rupani bhogayatanani stula sharirani cha utpadyante. Now what are these stula shariras? Stula shariras are part of stula prapancha itself, but they are in keeping with whatever is the sharira deserved by a particular jiva based on the karma, which leads to karma phala, and the bhoga is possible only in that particular upadhi sharira. One cannot be in manushya sharira and get deva sharira sukha, meaning sharira sukha which is possible in that kind of a sharira. Even across genders, what a man or a woman feels, that cannot be compared exactly so, because sharira is different. Just like sukha dukkha, both, not only dukkha or sukha, either of the two, you cannot compare across sharira. Shariras are different, but they are not sadhana. Indriyas you can compare, saying that there are sadhanas. If their indriyas are similar, then you can say indriyas can be compared, but you cannot compare shariras. They are not sadhana. They are the abode. They are the ashraya for indriyas, for the jiva. It becomes an ashraya for bhoga. Itham sankshepena srishti yukta. This is supposed to be sankshepa as per the sagarakara, vichara sagarakara. So he says, itham sankshepena srishti yukta maya vaibhavasya vistarena nirupanam tu कोटि ब्रह्मायुषापि न शक्यते. सो माया एक्सप्लेनेशन इज नॉट पॉसिबल. इसे सृष्टि आई कैन समहाउ एक्सप्लेन इन ब्रीफ, बट कोटि ब्रह्मायुषापि, इवन इफ ब्रह्मा, देर आर यू नो कोटि ब्रह्मास ऑल्सो कम अबाउट. ब्रह्मलोक, कोटि ब्रह्मास मीन्स कोटि ब्रह्मलोक, सच कल्पास ऑल्सो गो अवे, स्टिल माया वैभवस्य विस्तरण निरूपम निरूपणम न शक्यते. This is what Gitacharya Krishna also says. Everything that I have told you about Vibhuti, Vibhuti Yoga is what? The Vibhutis are discussed. Arjuna asked, Keshu Keshu Visheshu, describe each and every Vishaya, wherever I should think about you. How do you manifest? He says, I'll give a sampling. Across chapter and multiple chapters also, he has given a sampling only. And then he says, you extend it to everything wherever you see this. Yajyad Vibhuti Mat. Anything that has vibhuti, that is all my manifestation. What about others? Others are also mine, but you will have difficulty seeing that. You start seeing the good as me first. Something which is mind-bogglingly good, you start looking at that as Ishvara. That is the tatparya. Then you extend it to other things also. Everything is Ishvara. Isha vasya midam sarvam yatkinchi jagatyam jagat tena tyaktena bhunjita magrata kasya siddhanam, says the Isha Upanishad opening mantra. So everything is Ishvara, that is the tatparya. All this srishti has, there has to be apavada done. So maya srishta padarthanam nanta asti iti valmikihi vasishte na nana itihasehi nirupitavan. So valmiki vasishte, in vasishta grantha, Valmiki has said, and nana itihasai api, in other itihasas also nirupitavan, Valmiki nirupitavan. What is that? Mayas srishta padartham na anta asti. There is no end to maya srishta padartha. Even scientists say that universe is ever expanding. We know but a little. Aunsha we know. Whatever you know, the more you know that so little you know. The more you know, there is more to know. Therefore, your knowledge, as the knowledge increases, you know that how limited your knowledge is, because there is so much to know. Therefore, ignorance is bliss. Is in that sense, it is said that it does not overwhelm you. It does not intimidate you. But really, if you expand yourself, it should not intimidate you. There is so much to know. It cannot ever be known. Except that you cannot objectify any. Everything cannot be objectified, cannot be known. Therefore, maya srishta padarthanam na anta asti iti valmiki vasishte nana itihasaihi nirupitavan. This is the srishti. Now we'll move on to more interesting parts. Atma viveka atva panchakosha viveka. So all these panchakoshas are mentioned as srishta, part of stool and sukshma sharira, which are part of stool and sukshma prapancha, which are born out of stool and sukshma panchamahabhutas, which are born out of Ishvara, which is maya, along with who is maya sahita chaitanya. This maya sahita chaitanya karana pervades through and through into karya. That karya finally is jiva sharira, along with the sukshma sharira, stula sharira, which are categorized as koshas, layerings, from which you have to separate out the real self. That is the prakriya we look into in the next part. Sukhan nityam swaprakasham vyapakam nama rupe adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drukyatva nirunaparam sarvedanta vidyam pratyak paramha tadeva annamattonyat iti me nishchitamatihi. Namaste. I hope there are no questions regarding this. This is something that we have seen, so I sped through it. We didn't want to spend much time there. Okay. Namaste.
Namaste, Guru. Tomorrow there is.
Tomorrow there is Prathama. So Pratipada. We'll take a break.
Yeah, till evening 7 p.m.
Yeah, yeah. So I'll see you day after. Namaste.
Tuesday. Hari Om.